today we're going to cook some fish, some flounders. We're going to learn how to cook flounders, and we're just going to make some bacon because I feel like making bacon. So let's add some bacon. Let's make some bacon. And the George Foreman is a great bacon machine. It sucks for making doughs, but the bacon is our talent. See it? See that bacon over there? I'm gonna close that up. I'm trying to have a little bit of bacon. For breakfast, we're gonna have that for breakfast. Now, this is what we're gonna do. I'm gonna show you how to a little trick. We're gonna have butter, black pepper, salt, granulated garlic, red crushed peppers, and the pan over there, of course. Now let's start. So what we're gonna do, we're gonna heat up the oven. I'm gonna put a little bit of salt in, just a little bit. Some garlic, because I like garlic. Make sure to do it to both sides. I'm just gonna make sure it don't defrost it too good. Now we're gonna turn this on here. Just hit my head on this one. That's okay. And this little wild card in there. And now, I just forgot to put one thing. The red pepper. See how it's gonna come out. Throw it in the other time. Now we have a situation. We don't have any more olive oil. And that is a huge problem when it comes to cooking. So what we're gonna do instead is we'll give our old friend coconut oil a try. I've never cooked with coconut oil. Fish, that is. Be very liberal. And you're wondering why the butter is here. You're gonna see why. So I'm just gonna let this sizzle a little bit, you know, mix it up. Sizzle, sizzle, sizzle. Just a little bit of sizzling, though. Just a little bit. Yes. Sizzle for me. See how it's getting? The vapors come out. Sure. Put the fish in now because it's good now. Let's see how it goes. good. Watch. Lower the heat. Put the side that I didn't put this on. See how it's cooking. It's gonna be quick because it's such a small piece. You don't want to flip it all the time. This is fish. You don't want to flip fish all the time. Let it cook by itself. It's kind of chilly here, so I'm gonna warm myself up a little bit. Now, excuse me, I'm gonna wash my hands really quick. I'm gonna check the bacon as well. You're golden. Just can't overcook it. Let's see how the bacon's doing. Welcome to my kitchen. Now we're gonna throw a little wild card in here. A teaspoon of butter, just because we can. I haven't cleaned anything the whole day either, so. The smell of the butter and the coconut oil is invigorating. Let's take a look at the bacon. Yes, it's a kitchen mess. I don't care. Yeah, George Foreman does impress with the bacon, not the burger though. You don't want to overcook the fish because that is going to be bad. Seems like everything should be in order. This fish is cooked. Unfortunately, I made a boo-boo on the fish. I flipped it too hard and it's too thin. So it's a little bit messed up. That butter, letting it soak in there, it's gonna make a deliciousness. I also forgot to have lemon in here, so it's an interesting taste. Spit it in. Yeah, not the prettiest setup, but you know what? It's protein. Deal with it. Still gonna need it, I don't care how ugly it looks. Some oil in this, just for the heart attack. Yeah, like that. Ah, delicious. And we're just gonna add another thing to it. Maybe we're not gonna add it because I'm happy. Let's go to the bacon. I'm telling you, George Foreman is the bomb. Let's look how the other side is. Deliciousness. Ready to serve. The thing with the George Foreman is that the top bacon always gets cooked faster. No, it's the moment. I'm super hungry, I'm not gonna look at the bacon. Look who's calling me. Look who's calling me. Where are you in the face? Hello?